Hi everyone, this is Aeon Laser, I'm Harry. In this video, we will give you some tutorials about autofocus and manual focus. As for the autofocus, we will teach you how to operate it, how to calibrate the focal length, some related precautions, and how to replace the laser pin. At the end of this video, we will show you the operation of manual focus. Now I will use this 6mm thick acrylic board to show you how to operate autofocus. And you need to put the board on the work table first. And the next step is to click the zero button on the control panel. And then select the autofocus. Press the enter button, it will start. Every time at end of autofocus, we can see that focus pin is pushed up by the processing material. When the light bulb is off, the sensor will send a signal to the controller of the machine, and it will send back a command to the Z-axis motor to descend automatically. When the table stops descending, the distance from the laser nozzle to the material surface is the best focusing position. The focal length we discuss here is the distance from the laser nozzle to the processing material. And the default focal length of our machine is 8.8 millimeters. However, when some default configurations changed, for example, you change the focus length with different focal length, it's necessary for you to find the best focal length again. And set in the software to continue to use the autofocus. So how to find the best focal length for your machine? The pulsing method is a popular approach to find it. You can use this wooden board and stick a piece of paper on the upper left corner. Then put it on the work area to pulse the laser on different distance to burn spots on the material. First, let's try 8.8 millimeters. Just click pulse. Then 10.7. Then 11.7. 7.4. 5.8. The next step is looking for the smallest point. As you can see that this is the smallest point. So the 8.8 millimeters is the best focal length. Well, when the best focal length is found, it needs to be reset in the software. So first, I will show you how to reset the focal length in RDWorks. First, you need to click the user table here and then select other. The focus depth below is what we call the focal length. You can see that the default optimal focal length is 8.8. If you found that your latest optimal focal length is 7.8 after testing, you can change it to 7.8 here. As for the Lightburn, the principle is the same. First, select the edit menu, then click machine setting and select read here to read the parameters of the linked machine. Here you can see the focus distance, which is the place to set the focal length. Similarly, you can change it to the parameters that need to be changed, such as 7.8 millimeters. Well, there are some precautions about autofocus. First, when using the conical table, never leave it empty when using the autofocus. Otherwise, the laser pin will easily get stuck in the honeycomb table and damaged. Second, the function cannot be used when processing soft materials such as clothes, laser, and paper on honeycomb table because it is easy to get the laser pin stuck in the hole of honeycomb. Third, when taking out the processing materials, lower the platform first before you take it out. Otherwise, it is easy to damage the laser pin. The fourth precaution is when you use the blade table, you also need to be careful that never use autofocus when the table is empty. The fifth and also the last precaution is the material should be placed stably between the two blades, because the overturning of the material will also cause the laser pin to get damaged. As for the precautions I just mentioned, the main concern is that the focus pin is easy to be damaged accidentally. Now I will teach you how to replace it if you are really unlucky to damage it by accident. In the toolbox attached to our machine, there are some spare laser pins and a specific screwdriver. And the second screwdriver is used to replace the laser pin. First, you need to loosen the screw in this small hole. And then loosen the original laser pin by hand directly. And then install the new one. Finally, remember to put the small screw back. Well, all done. Very easy. In any case where autofocus is not suitable, or you are already very familiar with the machine, you can use manual focus. In the toolbox, there's such a small acrylic ruler with a length of 26 millimeters. When focus manually, just put one side of the ruler on the surface of the material and align the other side with the cross-section of the metal nozzle. Then move the Z-axis, and when the small square is almost clamped, the focusing is completed. These are all about autofocus and manual focus. We will have more tutorials and tips about the laser machine in the future videos. If you are interested, feel free to subscribe to our channel. See you later. Yeah.